am the way, the truth, and the life, says the Lord. No one comes to the Father except through me.
Grabbing is full of garbage. So you see the hole is there. It's not a small, it's like even a small concrete. No? It's just full of garbage. It's floating there around in jail. So it was really hazardous and smelly. And so they complained to me, why you have to bring us, why do you have to bring us here? This is part of the history of Binondo, Estero de Binondo. Because Estero de Binondo during the 16th and up to early 20th century was like Venice. It is the waterway of Manila, Chinatown. So there are houses along the Estero. In order to enter those houses, you have to ride a small boat. And then they travel into Manila Bay through that Estero. So it's very important. Then I said, if you want to see how was it before, you can go to yung sa Bataan. Taga Bataan. Nasa Bataan lang dito. Sa Bataan yung Plaza sa Pilipinas yung ako sa atin. So mahal nga lang kung pumasok. Pero he tried to rebuild the old Manila on his property. Then you will see the old Binondo, how it looked like. Very beautiful. You know, I was just thinking while ako, meron naman dito yung Benicia. Yung Estero na natin, yung tatanan ng Tapos, I haven't been there. So, hindi ko masyadong mahirin. So, that was Binondo. It was very beautiful. Until, you know, after World War II, it was destroyed. Manila was destroyed. And after that, people seem to have lost their order. Of course, you want them to survive after the war. So they already forget that medyo unnecessary things. You just wanted to eat. So Manila was turning to how it is now a confusing design of buildings, cars, and roads. It was not like that before. Fortunately, to some of them, they were not affected by World War II. Manila, I would say, would be more beautiful, but another one outside. And then we were not able to recover it, and then people really forgot about it and neglected it. So, how does it relate with our gospel today? You see, Jesus is telling us something about what to avoid. He wants us to go to heaven. That's why he came on this earth to save us. He wants us to go to heaven. But it will be our fault if we don't go to heaven. That if we go knocking at the doors of heaven and then we will not let in, sayang. Then how does it relate with Binondo before Binondo after? It could be said that our soul, ating mga kaluluwa, is like a beautiful garden when we were baptized. And it is not just to put it as a poetry. It's true. You know what happens in a soul when they were baptized? It's an infant or even an adult. Pag pinindigan ng mga yan, their original sins are removed and they are replaced with a sanctifying grace. Sanctifying grace means a share in the divinity of Christ. Pakikibahagi sa pag-agos ng ating Panginoon. Hindi man tayo pasang-pasamba. Tao tayo eh. Pero meron tayong bahagi ng pag-agos sa ating Panginoon. Simulan na tayo din. It is already very good. It's a wonderful thing that is happening in this earth, even now. That is sanctifying. Which, is it up tayo? You know, when Christ came to save us, He adopted us. God the Father adopted us as His children. Kaya natin mga nangyikanap ng Diyos, may tawag. Kaya natin may mga may tayo tinatawag na alam ng Diyos. We are adopted because God the Father's only one Son, Jesus Christ. You know, He adopted us as His children. Inanggap tayo. But in the human situation, kapag tayo inanggap at nagkampo ng isang tao, yung inanggap mo, the one you adopted, all has all the rights as your natural child. Pwede mo maibigay sa rin mong ito. Hampon pa rin. Although the rights and everything, he is entitled to receive with education, inheritance, etc. But when God adopted us as His children, it's like we were being given a blood transfusion. Kaya tayo dugo ng ating kaluluwa. And that blood is a sanctifying force. May bahagi na tayo ng Panginoon mula sa Diyos. And it should make us wonder how beautiful a soul is under the state of grace, sanctifying grace. That what has happened, that is happening first when we are baptized. And along the way, because we are big human beings, we don't find if we are, we give up easily to the temptations of the devil, to the temptations of this world. And then when we commit mortal sin, we cut off this relationship with God. And then we remove from our souls this sanctifying grace. So the participation in the divine nature of God is done. So we say mortals, those souls who are in state of mortal sin are dead. Because they already remove from themselves the divinity. So, a soul that is once beautiful because of sanctified grace can become ugly because of mortal sin. And then, a soul who dies in a state of mortal sin, when he goes up to heaven, up on the door of St. Peter, he won't be recognized. Wala ka tayo. You cannot be here in heaven because you will be contradicting what heaven means. Heaven meaning the company of all the holy ones. So that's what our Lord is trying to warn us, or trying to remind us, to always have this in mind, our own salvation. Now, He is calling us to walk through the narrow gate. I said we are way too many times that there is not enough to make a list of mga nagkasala. Kaya may mahina lang nagkasala. Then if that is your reason that you gave up, then you're not walking along the path. Okay? To be a Christian would be difficult. And much more difficult if we only rely on ourselves. But since we are children of God, we are entitled to this. Whatever Jesus received in His lifetime, we are also entitled to receive as children of God. So, to live as a Christian, the first thing we have to do is to pray and ask for the grace to be a good Christian. No one is a good Christian by his own effort, by his or her own effort. We are good Christians because we have received the grace of God. And the grace of God, we must ask. Hihingi natin ng mga pagkakas. In fact, say, in the Gospel of St. John, anong sabi, without me, Jesus said, without me, you can do nothing. So if you want to live a good Christian, as good Christians, if you want to walk along this narrow gate, it's really very difficult, of course, but with the grace of God, further, there's another thing that we are blessed with other than the grace of God. This is called the mercy of God. When we fall into sin, we are not, we are separating ourselves from God. It seems like we don't merit anymore to be human. I say we already went against God whenever we sin. It would be like just for God. The moment we committed mortal sin, just destroy the speed. So, hindi ka naman nasunod. Dapat, I'm just a boom. Wala ka na sa ito. But because God is merciful, He allows us to convert. He gives us the opportunity na magbabang. Before